we need to begin our service today by me wishing all of you a very happy anniversary. Maybe you can stand and wish each other a happy anniversary too. Happy anniversary. Well, as you can see, it's a little bit different of a service today. You might be, I'm doubting you'll be disappointed that there's no printed sermons at the back, and there really is no long sermon today. Oh. But we are celebrating our anniversary with all kinds of different folk involved in our service today. Just a few announcements I want to draw your attention to. I wanted to hallmark that today is not only our anniversary, it's also Charles, wave Charles. It's Charles's birthday today. And so happy birthday to Charles. We have our old friend, and it's hard to believe I'm calling him an old friend because I think he's about 24, Justin Mackey here with us today. And we're delighted to have him here. And Justin just released a new CD, and all of us who are part of Knox, we know Justin sang in our choir for a number of years, and he's pursuing his musical career, and I've heard that he maybe stashed a few CDs in his bag, so if you would like to see him after the service and pick up one of his CDs, that would be great. And I just was talking to someone in the church, and they said, we need to know his schedule. They're checking online because he's singing around the community and they want to sing to Knox delegation to some bar in London, so that'll be good fun. I wanted to thank Linda White. Linda is, I don't think she's here today. I know she sent me an email and said she was not feeling well, but she set up our display, our anniversary display downstairs, and I hope you'll take a minute and have a look at that. The flowers in our sanctuary today, and there's two sets of flowers. The ones on my left honor and remember Bob Boyle, whose funeral was just this past week. And the ones on the right are an anniversary present from our friend Hans Vanderveen, who is in doing some setup here. So thank you to Hans. Reminder that this afternoon is our Welcome to St. Thomas event for those who are new to St. Thomas, and there are too many people for me to list them all that have done a boatload of advertising. People like Dan Russell and Jim Carrey, who've done a lot of door knocking and handing out of brochures. Anna Russell, who's called, I think, every business in St. Thomas and got fabulous door prizes. And so thank you to all of the people who made that happen. And that's this afternoon starting at 2. And then tonight at 7, we're all invited back to church for a great folk and bluegrass concert by the Lost Pilgrims. And that's a group of Presbyterian ministers who have formed a really great bluegrass and folk band. And it's a fundraising concert. You can read about it in your bulletin. This coming Friday is our first $5 Family Friday, and it's a Mexico night, Mexican night, in Rodney Hall. For $5, we will feed your entire family with tacos and all kinds of Mexican food and a yummy dessert. And it's for our church, it's also for our community. We're trying to target people who have kids under 18. So you're not going to be carded at the door, but we will be looking. Did you bring somebody under 18 with you? Because it's really a ministry for our families. This includes grandparents bringing grandchildren and letting parents have a night out. So please, if you have grandchildren, we'd love to have you come and bring them for this evening. Don't worry if you're late, because we're keeping, it's really a meal. So you're going to come in. We're going to feed you well, and if you need to run out to whatever activity you have going on, you are welcome to do that. Finally, a reminder to our elders, if you can pick up your session packages from Bob Holt following the service today. Now, Knox Presbyterian Church St. Thomas, it was established in 1837 in connection with the Church of Scotland. And then our congregation was known as St. Andrew's. And the first sanctuary that St. Andrew's worshipped in was on New Street, and it was a frame construction. The second brick church on the site of the present post office at Talbot and Mary Street, it was completed in 1865. Now, less than 20 years later, this Presbyterian church was bursting at the seams. And so they built a new and larger church building right here. In 1887, a mission church was established, and that became known as Alma Street Presbyterian Church. And it was right around that time when Alma Street came into being that St. Andrew's changed its name and became Knox. Now, in those early years when Presbyterians gathered for worship, there were no organs, there were no guitars, and there were no pianos. Presbyterian congregations only used their voices when they united in song, and the words that they sang were only scripture. And so our call to worship today is a song, and you may notice you've got some choir members sitting beside you in the pew. They're going to help us a little bit with this. It's a song we learned last year, so hopefully your memory is good from last year. You can find it printed in your bulletin. It's called God Welcomes All. And I know that Maggie is going to come and help us, and Sharong is going to help us. Sharong's here somewhere. Come on up, because if you're like me and you sort of read music but not so well, you need to hear it once or twice to refresh your memory. So we're going to start with this section. We're just going to remain seated. This section, only women. Only women, this section. And you're going to sing. Can you sing for us the soprano line? And now we're going to speed it up just a little bit because we're like, it's our anniversary. So we're going to try it again, and maybe you can play with us too, can you, so that we can get it? And it's going to go like this. God welcomes all strangers and friends. God's love is strong and it never ends. Okay, now we're just going to sing it with Maggie and just the women. Here we go. God welcomes all strangers and friends. God's love is strong and it never ends. Okay, do you feel okay with that? Oh, so confident. Okay, women on this side, you are only women. You're going to be the alto, and Maggie's going to, I'm going to help the sopranos eventually, which is somewhat scary, but oh well. Go ahead, Maggie, can you sing the alto for these ladies? So can you try it with her? I'm not going to try it. You need to try it. Ready? Okay, so Maggie, can you use your hands for them a little bit? When they go up, put your hand up, and when they're going down, go down. Okay, here we go. You're going to try it again. Ready? God welcomes all strangers and friends. God's love is strong and it you feeling okay? What I love about is that there's people out there who go, yep, and then there's a lot of people that are like, okay, Sharong is going to do the men, all the men. Look at the bass line, and let's listen to it. Go ahead, Sharong.
God welcomes all strangers and friends. God's love is strong and it never ends.
Okay, and Sharong, you have to help the men too. Okay. Go ahead, men. One more time for the men. How do you feel, men? Sort of like the altos. A few of these, a few of these. Okay, we're gonna try it. And as I said to Martin, what is the worst case scenario today? We fail. And we all sing the soprano. Oh well, that won't be bad. So what we're gonna do is the sopranos are gonna start, we're gonna sing it through once, and then we're gonna keep going. Okay, just keep repeating the soprano. As we sing, after we've sung once, Maggie, you're gonna really like, give them a big sign, lead boldly, yeah? Don't be afraid, altos are gonna start. Especially sing their starting notes strong. And maybe Martin will just give them a note to hear that. Yeah. No, but we might need you to conduct at that point. Okay, just listen for Maggie. And then Sharong is gonna do the same thing the third, when it starts the third time, okay? And we're gonna sing it until Martin tells us to stop singing it. So a couple times. Yeah, yeah. When Martin puts his hands on his ears, we know it's over. Okay, are we ready? So Martin, you can maybe go in the middle and help us a little bit. And Maggie, if you can help me with just get the start of the soprano, that would really help me. Because I'm no soloist. God. Are we ready? God welcomes all. Let's join together in prayer. Let us pray. Holy God, we lift our voices in praise today because we are grateful for this church. And we give you thanks today for those who have given of themselves freely in generations past and so have left us a legacy of a beautiful building and a warm church family. Loving God, as we celebrate our church anniversary, we are aware that you always call us to confession. And so in faith, we bring you the times when we as your church have missed the mark. We bring to you times when we were governed by fear rather than faith. We bring to you those moments when we failed to see the face of Christ in a stranger. God of hope, forgive us and bless us as we seek to be your church again. For we pray in the name of Christ, who taught us when we pray together to also say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Our opening hymn is number 299, Holy, Holy, Holy. And this was a hymn that for years our service began with. The day after Halloween, November 1st, is one of those holidays or holy days that we in the church and often in the world, we sort of skip over nowadays. It's called All Saints' Day. And it's a day that the faithful have set aside since the years of the early church to honor those who have gone before. It's a reminder that Christianity is not just about me or about me and Jesus. Sometimes, if you're like me, it's easy to think that it would be easier if it was just about me and Jesus, but it's not. And this thing called faith, it is bigger than any one of us. This thing called faith is bigger even than all of us who are gathered here this morning. And so on this All Saints Sunday, we celebrate our church anniversary. And we remember the roots of this celebration. It sprang from a conviction that there is a spiritual connection between heaven and earth. All Saints Day reminds us that when we join the church, we are not just joining this congregation in 2018. We are joining a fellowship of believers that stretches across the world and stretches over 2,000 years. We are connected in some way that is beyond our understanding right now. To all of those faithful ones who first sang in this congregation. So there's no long sermon today, but there is music that reminds us that we are a part of this great all-spanning family. There's no long sermon, but we'll be honoring longtime members and remembering those who have led them to faith. There's no long sermon, but we'll be welcoming new members into our midst. And we'll be worshiping alongside the youngest members of our church. Happy anniversary, Knox Presbyterian. May God bless us today in our worship and in the years to come. I need to make sure that I mention two people before we continue with our service. One is Hans, who did... I always think that Hans was so well named because he's often using his hands here at the church. And he came and did our setup today, or for today earlier in the week. I also wanted to thank Dion, who you saw running down. You might notice if you look way up that there's some lights upstairs right now. And we're trying out some different things to help with our video ministry, and this was a rental, and we're just experimenting with it a little bit. We've also added all this extra sound, so he's running today. Today is a special day here at Knox. Not only are we welcoming new members, but we're honoring those who have been a part of our congregation for many years. So I want you to think about 50 years ago. So is there anyone here who's 10 today? Any 10-year-olds? Any 9-year-olds? Oh, you're older than 10. Are you 10, Mackenzie? You're 9. So I want you to think Mackenzie times more than 5. 10 years back, and then another 10 years back, and then another 10 years back, all the way to 50 years back. 50 years ago, Pierre Elliott Trudeau was the Prime Minister of Canada. 50 years ago, when people turned on their radio, they were listening to Hey Jude by the Beatles and Simon and Garfunkel singing Mrs. Robinson. 50 years ago, that was the year Robert Kennedy and Martin Luther King Jr. were both assassinated. That was the year that the Boeing 747 made its maiden voyage. And if you went to the movies, you saw a movie called Planet of the Apes. 50 years ago, here at Knox, the following people became church members. And first, I'd like to ask Bob Holt to come forward. Bob Holt became a member 50 years ago, and perhaps more than most, he has given his time and his energy to this congregation in those last 50 years. No, sweetheart, I'm okay. And so he's got his own certificate, which is somewhat funny. Bob, it has been a privilege to work with you here at Knox, and this congregation has no idea what a commitment you've made to this congregation in the last 50 years and how well you've served it as clerk of session.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'd also like to invite Gene Powers to come forward. And Gene's brother, Morris, also joined the church 50 years ago. And we're going to make sure he gets his certificate. He's living in a nursing home in London now. And I'd like to invite Jim Lyle to come forward. Jim? Congratulations, Gene. And please come over. Congratulations, Jim. Thanks for coming. Now, 75 years ago, William Lyons Mackenzie King was the Prime Minister of Canada. And Canadian troops were immersed in the throes of World War II. And if you turned on your radio, you would hear a band called the Glenn Miller Band playing In the Mood. A baby was born 75 years ago that went on to score the most famous goal in Canadian hockey history. That was Paul Henderson. And that was the year that Louise Sifton joined the church 75 years ago. Now, Louise, I know, is here somewhere. There she is. Louise, could you come forward? As she comes forward, I need to tell you that Louise grew up here at Knox. She went to Sunday school here at Knox, just like Ellie. And maybe during coffee time, you can ask Louise about a little story of her getting into a bit of mischief when she was in Sunday school here at Knox. Congratulations, Louise. We're grateful for you. It's a rare day when you can recognize a member that's been a part of the church for 75 years on the same day as you're welcoming newcomers.
And still looks young.
And she still looks young. That's absolutely right. I'd like to invite the following people to come forward to profess their faith and join our congregation. Jennifer Bartley, Paul Bartley, Terry Comagen, Shirley Shore, Brenda Walden, Pam Noble, Carol Palmer, and Lori Szymanski. Could I ask you to just move back just a little bit? Thank you, sweetheart. And I see Pam is coming with her good friend Donna, just as an extra little bit of support. I ask all of you who are here and present today, do you believe that this world was created by God and that you are a child of God made in the divine image? And do you believe in Jesus Christ, who came as a child, who walked the earth and knows its joys and its sorrows, who died and rose again so that we might know forgiveness and life? And do you believe that God is active in our world still through the work of the Holy Spirit? And do you desire independence on the power of God to continue your journey of faith alongside all of us, your brothers and sisters in Christ here at Knox Presbyterian? I invite the congregation to turn with me to the congregational promise, which is printed in your bulletins. And you can find that on page 3 of the inserts. Let's read together. We welcome these people joyfully and reverently into our family, the family of God, here at Knox Presbyterian. We promise to walk beside them in faith, to uphold them in prayer, and to grow with them in faith as brothers and sisters in Christ. We promise to celebrate their joys and stand beside them in their sorrows. May God keep us together in this place so that we are enabled to enter for worship and to leave to serve. I invite Bob Holt as clerk of session to come forward and present the certificates of membership. And it's our tradition that all of the elders also come forward. Perhaps they can come along that aisle and come across to extend the right hand of fellowship.
Thank you.
That reminds me that we did elect new elders this fall, didn't we? That's a lot of elders. Our scripture today is taken from the book of Psalms. It's one of those passages that the people of God for years have been called to worship hearing, and we're just going to listen to a portion of it. Psalm 100, make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into God's presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is God who made us, and we are his. The Lord is good. God's steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. Well, I promised you not a long sermon today, and in fact, at the very beginning of this week, I wasn't going to speak at all. I had a vision. We were going to listen to an entire sermon preached by Harry Rodney. And so, I spent a good portion of this week going back over old videotapes of Knox Church. And then I realized we were welcoming new members and recognizing long-term members, and that we wanted our children to be a part of worship. And while Harry was a magnificent preacher, I knew we couldn't listen to an entire Harry Rodney sermon this morning. But as I began to watch those videotapes, I saw something. In those videos, I realized something about this congregation. I saw services where the choir was all dressed in red robes. I didn't realize you'd had red gowns before. And the organ, it was tucked up where the pulpit is now in those videotapes. I saw a much younger Bob Holt present certificates of membership to people. I saw Sylvia and Ward Houghton bring their daughter Taylor to be baptized. And Taylor is now 24, and she's a teacher in London. I saw Marg Vogan, who died last year at 104, singing in the church choir. I saw Bonnie and Tony Stackpool sitting together in church. I saw longtime member Hal Calvert, who many of you remember. He passed away 5 or 6 years ago. I saw him take up the collection alongside Bev Gloyne. And I saw women in dresses and jackets with those extra padding power suits from the late 80s and the 90s. And I saw some of you men with more hair and with very big acrylic glasses. So many changes I saw. But what I realized is Knox Church is still weirdly Knox Church. And as I watched those videos, despite the changes, it still felt like home. And I don't know about you, but when I gather here for worship some Sundays, I can almost hear echoes of the past. And I think if we listen hard today, we might even hear a few whispers from the future. That's what the early church was getting at when they set aside a day called All Saints' Day. It was a day to remember those who are no longer with us, but who somehow journey with us still. It's a day to remember that this church is not an organization or a club. There is something more sacred going on here. So there's no sermon today, but I did think we might like to hear a voice from the past. And if technology does not fail us, which it sometimes does, I invite you to listen with me to the voice of Harry Rodney, reading words of scripture that remind us of our calling to be a light to the world.
The scriptures of the New Testament, the 5th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, reading the first 16 verses. Now when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up onto a mountainside and sat down. His disciples came to him, and he began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled by men. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden, neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Amen. May God follow with his blessing this reading of this portion of his holy word.
As God has blessed our congregation, so we seek to be a blessing to the world. The offering will now be received.
I am down, and all my soul so weak. When troubles come, and my heart hurt me, then I am still, and wait here in the silence. Till you come and sit a while with me, you raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I shoulders, you raise me up to more than I can be.
Let us pray. Holy God, we give you thanks for the gifts we see and the more valuable gifts of hope and joy. that we hold in our hearts. Lord, bless our offerings today. Multiply them so that your will may be done. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Please be seated. Our prayer today, our second prayer, is a responsive prayer of thanksgiving, and you can find it printed on the insert page. And our reader today is Lucas Abdi, along with Mavis Currie. And I actually need, could you just hand me a bulletin? Could I borrow your bulletin? Thank you. Let's join together in prayer. Let us pray.
Gracious and loving God, we give you thanks for all the people who have worshiped here at Knox. We thank you for your journey alongside us.
We give you thanks for this church building in which we gather and for all of the memories that we have made here.
We give you thanks for our past and for the future you have prepared for us.
Protect us, guide us, and sustain us as we seek to be your church in the world. Let's sing together our closing hymn, number 757, Come Sing, O Church in Joy.
Thank you.
now let us go in peace, and may the grace of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest, remain, and abide with each of you and all whom you love this day and forevermore.